Vincent! We happy?
Yeah, we happy.
I'm in the mood for something kind of snacky. I wonder what we got in the old kitchen. Let's see. Well, we got some Jell-O no-bakes, Basta, Nesquik. There's nothing really snacky there. Malto meal, Cocoa Puffs, Cookie Crisp, some croutons. What am I gonna do? Chips. No, I'm not in the mood for chips. We got some bread. Let's see. Oh, the banana. I wonder. Let's see here. You know what? I think it might be time for the Snacktastic Challenge.
Hey, sewer rat may taste like pumpkin pie, but I never know because I wouldn't eat the filthy motherfuckers.
Hey, everybody, making the sandwich. So Stastic's got a favorite snack, and he showed everybody what it was a while back. And I thought I'd give it a go. When I got to thinking about this, Pete, there's actually a lot of different variables involved, even though there's only four ingredients. Got my banana, and I was wondering about firmness of the banana, because you know if you eat the banana when it's a little more green, it's a little more bitter, it's not as sweet. If you wait a little longer, it is sweeter. And I wondered what would be better on a sandwich. And I wasn't sure, so actually, the banana, I bought them when they were green, but it's kind of on its way out, but we're going to use it because I didn't get around to doing this too quickly. Also, another variable would be the type of cheese you use. I thought it would be better to shred it myself, personally, than sit there and buy shredded cheese. So I'm shredding the cheese. And the police are driving by. That's probably a good amount of cheese there for the challenge. I'm just using a mild cheddar. But I got to thinking about that too. I think you used a white cheddar or something. But there's tons of cheese, as well as just buying unshredded or shredded and shredding it yourself. There's also a bunch of different types. But so we're going to go with a mild cheddar on ours. And also a third variable is the bread. You could go with white bread, a wheat bread, a multigrain, rye. Rye didn't sound too good with this sandwich, so I'm gonna go with a whole wheat. So we got our whole wheat bread, two slices. Then there's the butter. I got shed spread, country crock. That's just a spreadable butter. Pretty good stuff. I think we're going to go light on the butter, Pete. Everybody. Light on the butter. And I don't remember if you buttered both sides, but I'm buttering both sides. This is exciting, folks. Okay, got our bread buttered. Big shot of my arm. Okay, last but not least is the banana. And I don't know if I got a cutting board or not. I don't think that's necessary. We'll just move it over. We're mixing the cheese and the banana anyway, so might as well cut them together. I think, Pete, you chunked yours like this, but I think I'm going to cut it long ways instead. So we're going to cut it into two pieces that are about equal size. We're going to go ahead and sprinkle the cheese on one side. We'll do both sides. We'll put the banana in the middle. That's looking pretty good there. Okay, now we're going to take the banana. I'm just going to cut it lengthways. Put it on like this. Three big old pieces there. And we're going to try this out, folks. Might take it back to the command station so we can give it a proper tasting, so to speak. So I'm going to sign off for a minute. All right, folks. Got my sandwich here. I did not swap it out. You can see that it is the same sandwich. I did not swap it out for something else. And actually, I don't think it sounds that bad. But we're going to cleanse our palate with a little water. I'm going to make sure it got no other flavors in our mouth before we sample. This is a big sandwich, too. All right, folks, here we go. That's not too bad. Actually, the cheese flavor, you don't even really taste the cheese as much because the banana... It might be because the banana is a little older and it is sweeter. I think if it was more firm, it might not be as sweet, but... I don't know. I dig it. It's good. Definitely worth giving a try. It might not be for everybody, but... I'm going to finish the sandwich. I'm not going to sit here and finish it in front of you, but I'll finish it. And I'll probably eat another one some other day. So anyway, folks, if you were curious about whether or not this sandwich is worth its salt, so to speak, it sure is. It's pretty good. But to tell you the truth, when the flavors mix together, you really don't taste the individual flavors. It's just one, you know, kind of a more mixed flavor. So anyway, I'm sorry if I took my mouth full, folks. So anyway, I'm going to get out of here. I just thought I'd try a little Snacktastic action and see if it was as good as professed. So it is pretty dang good, so... I'm going to talk to y'all later. Bye.
This is a tasty burger.